Anish, a victory over Ivan Hao. Were you sort of lucky in the ending?
Yeah, obviously. I mean, it was a little bit similar to our previous game. I was putting a little bit of pressure throughout the whole game, but it is not enough to win normally. But okay, I did. I have to do what I have to do, and at the end, I was very lucky, of course.
A couple of years ago, you were at some point second in the world, and in the last couple of months, years, you have been struggling to come into the top 10. How did you work on that situation?
Well, I could be like Levon Aronian and say that, you know, I still consider myself to be world number two. In fact, I had never been world number two. I've been world number two once for a couple hours. I won my game against Wojtaszek in Qatar Open, and Vladimir Kramnik was world number two.
For some reason, I opened the website at that moment.
Yes, yes. And Vladimir Kramnik was playing his game, and I already finished my game. And he was world number two, and with that game, I overtook him, but he won his game, and the same day, I became world number three again. Yeah, I had some good results before. I've been very steady. Mostly my sort of downfall, sort of whatever you call it. I played very badly in two tournaments in a row. At some point in the Bilbao, I lost three, and in Singfield Cup, I had two tournaments with three losses and no wins. And that was an enormous blow to my rating. And ever since, I didn't have such blows anymore. But yeah, I didn't manage to quite get back. But it's normal. I mean, you know, they're always... people look at themselves, you know, when they ask such question, and they always say that, yeah, you know, I was struggling with something, but then, you know, I had an enlightenment. In fact, you should always keep in mind that there are many players who play this game, and we are all playing each other. So, you know, I let go a little bit of my form. Someone like, you know, Levon Aronian, for example, had a very good run, Shakhriyar Mamedyarov, and then it always happens that someone is a bit off, the other guy takes over. It also has to do with other players doing well, and I was obviously quite lucky the moment when I was world number three. I was getting a lot of luck everywhere. Lately it's been a bit tougher. I hope to get some luck again in the future.
Okay. After the first round, okay, nothing can be said. You're leading the tournament with Anand and Kramnik. Would you be surprised if they would continue to do very well in this tournament?
Yeah, so far indeed three veterans are doing very well in the tournament. But one game doesn't mean anything. It is for Kramnik and Anand, it is very good because they have both been rather unstable. I have been stable bad player. They have been unstable, and sometimes they have very good results. And for these two, the good start is very, very important. For Vichy, for sure, you know. And for Kramnik too, they are so unstable that a good start usually is a good sign for them. It means that they could end very high. But of course, we just started. Magnus has his own plans. He is just warming up, and so many great players here. Let's just wait and see.
Okay, Anish, thank you very much.
Thanks.